verse 15. But they crowned him not with the true crown, for that was with God in Creosheva. But they made one creating it in the sacred circle. But since he could not be crowned by those beneath him, they were in a quandary how to proceed. Then Satan spoke to Enuhasad, saying, command them to lie on their bellies in token of submission to thee, and say to them, lay the crown at my feet, and I will stand with my head bare. And when ye have prostrated yourselves, I will command the crown in my own name to rise up and lie upon my head. And if it so rise, then know ye of a truth, our work is the highest, best work. Verse 16. Enuhasas then repeated this to the lords and lordesses, and they laid them down on their bellies, each being innocuous to show fidelity in hope of exaltation. And when they were down and saw not, Enuhasas, having not power in light, said, crown of these most holy wise lords and lordesses of heaven and earth, arise thou and lie on the head of him who shall have dominion on earth and in these heavens. Verse 17. And thereupon he stooped down on the sly, and with his own hand raised it up and crowned himself, and commanded the lords to raise up. And lo and behold, some of the lords and lordesses said, they saw the second light of the soul, and that the crown rose of its own accord, being under the will of the circle. So here it shows how Enuhasad falsely crowned himself before his host of angels. And notice how it states he could not be crowned in truth because the real crown sat upon the head of true God, Son of Jehovah. Verse 18. And they clapped their hands, saying, all hail our God, all hail our God, all hail our God, proclaiming him in the east, west, north, and south. Now we're going to move into how Enuhasad took upon the title Dias, Divas, and the origin and power in the heavens and on earth. Book of Wars Against Jehovah, chapter 11, verse 1 through 17, it states, Enuhasad said, I, the Lord, your God, being the All-Highest, through your choice, decree, for sake of harmony and concern, in concert in our labors, the establishment of a dias. Verse 2, as the Kraoshevans have had a diva, or divinity, so will I have a diva. And by virtue of my own authority, I proclaim ye, my lords and lordesses, as the holy members thereof. So here Enuhasad is copying the divine counsel of true God, Son of Jehovah. Verse 3, as the diva hath been taught in these heavens, so also be the diva whereof I assume the chief head. Verse 4. As the diva had laws, so also shall our diva, and they shall be promulgated on the earth and taught to mortals as the laws of deity. Therefore, by my own voice I dissolve the diva of heaven, and it shall not be from this time forth forever. And whosoever of ye being members thereof shall this day resign the diva and send word to the ruler of Kraosheva for his benefit and for his kingdom's benefit. Verse 7. First, then I take unto myself Anuba, the Lord loved by you all, and he shall be my associate, and his title shall be Master of the Scales of Heaven, for he shall determine the grades of the spirits and send them to their respective departments. On earth his title shall be Savior of Men, Son of Dias. So here is the beginning of these concepts we find in ancient records. Verse 8. Second, though Hikas shall be ruler over Japheth, which is China, and its heavenly kingdom, and thy title shall be Tien, and of the first rank of God of the earth. So here Enuhasad called the Lord God Hikas to be called Tien, which was the name that God gave to the people of Japheth through the prophet Po. And now here they are corruptly using it. Verse 9. Third, though Wachisaj shall be ruler over India, which is Shem, and her heavens and her heavenly kingdom, and thy title shall be Satga, and of the first rank of God of earth. Verse 10. Fourth, though Chilimung shall be ruler over Arabinia and her heavenly kingdoms, and thy title shall be Osiris, of the first rank of God of the earth. So here the Lord God Chilimung was given the title Osiris. Verse 11. Fifth, though Baal shall be ruler over Hellas and her heavenly kingdom, and thy title shall be Baal, and of the first rank of God of the earth. So here is where the origin of Baal comes from. He was part of the heavenly government of God, and now working for Anuhasaj, as Anuhasaj is Lord God, second in rank below God. So the same Baal you see in ancient Canaan is this same angel whose heavenly kingdom was stationed over Hellas. Verse 12. 6. Though Ashtaroth shall be ruler over Persia and its heavenly kingdom, and thy title shall be Ashtaroth, of the first rank of goddesses of the earth. So here is the origin of Ashtaroth. She was part of the heavenly government of God and now working for Anuhasaj, as Anuhasaj is Lord God, second in rule below God. And this is the same Ashtaroth who you see in the east in Persia. And her heavenly kingdom was over Persia, and you can find her traces on the earth. Verse 13. 7th, though Phobi shall be ruler over Europe and her heavenly kingdom, and thy title shall be Phobi, and of the first rank of goddesses of the earth. Verse 14. 8. Though Hojab shall be ruler over Japan and her heavenly kingdom, and thy title shall be Hojab, and of the first rank of God of the earth. Verse 15. After that, the false god made appointments for the other divisions of the earth and their heavenly places. And after that, he said unto them, verse 16, all my gods and goddesses shall have thrones in their places, and holy councils and attendants as becometh gods of the first rank. And everyone shall have a capital city, subsidiaries, according to the number and place of their spirits and mortal subjects. Verse 17. And every god and goddess shall manage his or her own kingdom in his or her own way. But everyone shall nevertheless be tributary to my kingdom, according to the exception I put upon him or her. Verse 19. Hereupon the host relaxed from duty and made their resignations of the diva and sent them with messengers to God in Creosheva. But not one of them mentioned the new state of affairs resolved upon. On the next day, at the trumpeter's call, they assembled again, and Anuhasaj said unto them, come ye with me, and I shall show you the place of Horeb and its boundaries. For it shall not be my kingdom alone, but yours also, for my kingdom shall be the kingdom of your kingdoms. Here it makes mention that God was not informed of the new capital state of Anuhasaj. Verse 20. And they entered in Otivane, which is a spacecraft, and coming in the fourth belt below meteors, in the sign of the 12th arc of Shinvet. And Anuhasad said, from this time forth, this belt shall be called Horeb, and it shall be my place forever, and it shall be the central kingdom of all the earth's heavens. Verse 21. And the multitude said, hail, kingdom of Horeb, the holy hill, place of the Most High God. And it was known thereafter as the belt of Horeb, hill of God. It was a three-quarters belt, and the base thereof was 10,000 miles from the earth, and the summit was 15,000 miles high, inhabited within and without. And its ascending rank in grades was 20. That is, it was easily inhabited by spirits that attained to that grade, being above the grade of infants and Jujurs. And Jujurs are spirits of darkness. And above the region of hells and knots, except in cases of great panic. Now from the first place of Horeb, where Anuhasaj crowned himself, which was the eastern base of the hill, to the place for his capital city, he made a roadway and called it Lo Horeb, and it was the only opened roadway to the kingdoms below. So here Anuhasaj moves from the upper plateau to a lower plateau, which stated the fourth belt below meteors, to establish his new heavenly capital. And with that, I'd like to say peace and blessings and catch you on the next series of The Wars Against Jehovah called Anuhasaj Declares Himself Against Jehovah. Shalom.